Hello, and welcome to this Real Python course on Python's membership operators in and not in. My name is Martin, and I'm going to guide you through this course. I actually have another different favorite name for this course, which would be what's in a name, or more precisely, what's in a container, or actually even more precisely, what's in a container or an iterator. But let's go there in just a little bit for the sake of this introduction. So let's start off by thinking about why membership operators matter. They allow you to check if an item exists inside of a container or an iterator, and that allows you to do a couple of things in programming. To give you just a few real-life examples, you may want to use it to verify user access or permissions, to validate user input against expected values, to make sure that your users don't input anything that breaks your app, for example, to check if a file exists in a directory, to detect duplicate items when you're running a data processing pipeline. And we could continue this. There's a lot of use cases for Python's membership operators. Another thing to mention is that Python's membership operators in and not in allow you to build this type of logic in a clean and readable fashion. So you may often use it for running some sort of conditional checks. Okay, so they're important. Let's get an additional voice from the past. How Shakespeare may conclude, verily, they matter. In this course, you'll learn about Python's in and not in operators for membership checks, how they work with common data types. I'm not going to talk about all the data types they work with because there's a lot of them. Then you'll do a bit of practical coding by building an e-commerce scenario for a very, very small Victorian business owner. You'll look at some pitfalls when you run membership checks with generators, and you'll also get to implement a membership check in custom classes using one of the Dunder methods that allow you to do that. And there will be a little bit more Shakespeare in there, just for fun. So if this sounds fun and useful, then stick with me. In the next lesson, we'll look over the basics of the in and not in membership operators. In this lesson, I'll quickly walk you over the basics of in and not in. Then in the next lesson, we're going to hop into the REPL to do some coding. But let's start off by considering the basics of in and not in. So both of them are Boolean operators, so they return true or false, depending on the result of the membership check. The general form is that if you use the in operator, then you say value in container, and if you use the not in operator, it works the same, type it as value not in container. And like I already said previously, you'll often use them in conditional checks. I also mentioned that they work both with containers and iterators. You'll look into this a bit more later on, but most commonly you'll be using it with a data structure like a list or a tuple or maybe a string. But you can also use them with generators, for example, which are iterators. And we'll look at this a little bit later in the course. Which brings us to this slide that lists out all the different objects that you can use membership operators on. There's a lot of them. I'm not even going to read them out, but at the beginning, you'll see a couple of very common ones, and these are the ones we're going to look into because, first of all, there's too many to tackle in one course, and also, the syntax is always the same. That's the cool thing about these types of constructs in Python. To a certain degree, Python doesn't care what type of data structure you're checking membership on. You can use the same syntax across lists, strings, and even generators, and Python will handle the necessary differences under the hood. So it's good to know that you can use it on a lot of different objects. Also, it does work on many objects, but it doesn't work the same on all objects. One aspect of using this interface of just value in container across all of those objects is that Python under the hood actually does different things depending on what object you are checking the membership on. And I'll just talk about a couple of them. Most notably, sequences such as lists and tuples, they use iteration to check for membership. Strings, which use substring checking, and mappings such as dictionaries or sets, which use hashing. Now, you may think, okay, so Python uses different approaches, but how is that relevant? And truth is, it may not be relevant for you, but if you are running it on large data structures, it may be relevant because the performance is very different between these different approaches. Iteration is quite slow. Substring checking is a little bit faster because there are some C-level optimizations that Python does. And hashing on dictionaries and sets is very fast. So if you do need to do membership testing on very large data structures, then it's best to use a dictionary or a set. I'm not going to go into performance more, but if you're interested in that, then go ahead and check out the associated tutorial. You can click on the link if you have the slides handy, And the written tutorial goes a little bit into comparing the performance between these different approaches. All right, so that's enough theoretical intro. In the next lesson, you'll try out membership checks with a couple of common data structures. In this lesson, you'll try out using the membership operators with a couple of common data structures. So I'm here in a Python repo, and let's start off by checking whether a number is in a tuple. So I could say 3 in, and then I'll make a tuple here that contains 1, 2, and 3. So we already know the answer. And if I check, is 3 in the tuple 1, 2, 3? Python replies with, that's true, it's in there. Let's try another one. Let's try for a string. So I want to check whether the letter O is in the word rose. So I type O in quotes, in, and then in quotes, rose. And Python again replies with true. Now I could do the same. And if I say not in rose, Python replies with false. So as you can see, in and not in just do the inverse of each other. In this case, if Python finds the character O inside of the string rose, then it replies with true. And if you use not in, then it replies with false. Before we move on to different data structures, I want to point out something to be aware of when you're working with strings and membership operators, because the empty string in Python is a little special. So if I would go ahead and type this, 2 quotes without any other content in there, and then I say in, and again, let's stick with rows. What do you think this is going to return if I press enter? Well, it returns true, and it always will. In Python, the empty string is always part of any string. This is something to be aware of. On the other hand, if you add a white space character in between those quotes and then perform the check, it'll be false because there is no space in rows. So just a little gotcha to be aware of. The empty substring is always part of any string in Python. So much about strings. Let's move on to lists, which is maybe one of the most common things that you'll use this membership checks on. So I could check, is rows not in, and then I'll open up a list with 2 square brackets, and I'm going to type a couple of words in there, for example, sweet, red, and thorny. And if I press enter here, you'll see that Python returns true again, because the word rose is not inside of the list that contains a couple of words, but not the word rose. And then let's try one more with a dictionary too. So I'm going to make a dictionary first that we can reuse. Rose underscore dict equals opening and closing the curly braces. And then in here, I put a couple of key value pairs. I'm going to say name colon rose, both strings. And then also let's add smell colon sweet, also as strings. Okay, this is our rose dict. And now I can check for membership directly. I can say is name in rose dict, and it'll return true because Python iterates over the keys of the dictionary by default. So you can see that the name key is in there and the smell key would also be in there. So that would also return true. But if I were to say is rose in rose dict, just like that, then that'll be false because by default, Python just checks the keys. Now, if you do want to check the values, you'll have to add dot values at the end. Oops, I forgot to add an S here and just typed value instead of values. So Python gave me an attribute error. So let's go ahead and fix that. Rose dict dot values. This needs to be plural. This is going to allow me to access the values of the dictionary, not the keys. And now rows in rose dict dot values returns true. All right, so as you can see, all of these work in the same way, right? You use the value that you want to check, then you use the membership operator, either in or not in, and then specify the object that you want to check over. Like I said, often this is some sort of a collection, like a list or a tuple, but it can also be a mapping, like a dictionary, for example, or a set. So this should give you some sort of an intuitive understanding of what the membership operators do and also how you can actually use them on a lot of different objects. Now, enough of this really small example. Let's go ahead and build a slightly bigger script that uses the membership operators in practice.